The muscles of the posterior torso are again divided into muscles for inspiration, expiration, muscles for movement of the vertebral column, but most of the muscles that we can see on this torso model will be for movement of the extremities. First, I want to talk about muscles of the superficial back. Muscles of the superficial back are for movement of the upper extremity. On this model, we can see on the right side, coming from the back of the head and coming from an area known as ligamentum nuchae and the spinous processes of vertebra all the way down to T12, a triangular-shaped muscle that will come out and insert across the spine of the scapula. This is called the trapezius muscle. The trapezius muscle. It has fiber directions coming into the scapula from above, from medially, and from laterally. That means that the trapezius could elevate our scapula, it could retract our scapula, or it could depress our scapula. If we remove the trapezius muscle and go to the muscles just deep to that, on this model, I'm going to ignore a few of the muscles to the back of the head for now. We'll revisit those later. We can see a muscle coming from the neck into the scapula above the vertebral border of the scapula, above the spine of the scapula. This is called the levator scapulae muscle. It lifts the scapula. If I were to shorten that muscle, you would see the scapula would go up. Then, immediately below that, we see an area right at the base of the spine of the scapula and in the remainder of the vertebral border of the scapula. And we see two rhombus-shaped muscles, a small one and a large one, rhomboideus minor and rhomboideus major. These muscles help to retract as well as medially rotate the scapula. Some of the other muscles that we can see, not muscles of the superficial back, but we can see on this model, again, we will see them with the upper extremity model, supraspinatus muscle above the spine of the scapula, part of the rotator cuff, infraspinatus below the spine of the scapula, part of the rotator cuff, and teres minor, also part of the rotator cuff. We can also see teres major. Teres major goes to the anterior humerus. Although it does rotate the humerus, it is a medial rotator of the humerus, it is not part of the rotator cuff. So, superficial back muscles so far, the trapezius, levator scapulae, rhomboideus minor, rhomboideus major. The other muscle of the superficial back is called latissimus dorsi. Latissimus dorsi has origin from the lumbar fascia and the spinous processes up to about T7. We removed a chunk of it here. This portion, the upper portion, is deep to the trapezius. It wraps around anteriorly to insert into the intertubercular groove of the humerus, which makes latissimus dorsi an adductor, a medial rotator, and an extensor of the humerus. So those are muscles associated with the upper extremity that we can see on the back of the torso model. Now, there are a few other muscles. There are two sets of muscles which run on either side of the spine, known as the erector spinae muscle. Here we can see erector spinae muscle on this model. It would be deep to trapezius and deep to latissimus dorsi at this point, and they have removed it here in this section, so not a good view of latissimus or erector spinae. We also have a muscle here that you can see, although we removed most of it, is coming upward into the ribs. This is called the serratus posterior inferior muscle. The serratus posterior inferior muscle helps to pull ribs down. If you pull your ribs down, you're exhaling. So serratus posterior inferior is known as a muscle of expiration.